a appris à chanter en écoutant du Charlie Mingus et du Thelonious Monk. Couronnée meilleure artiste féminine de l'année en Angleterre, Amy Winehouse a déjà vendu plus de 4 millions d'exemplaires de son deuxième album.
Dry, you know, on when I hold my God. Your wind, the wild, you know, so far from all that old we went through. And I said, a troubled track.
d'existence et 4 albums, leur tournée gigantesque et leurs concerts spectaculaires ont fait du trio anglais Muse une référence mondiale du rock. Pour preuve, ils ont inauguré en juin dernier le stade de Wembley et ont joué devant plus de 180 000 personnes.
Bye. you already?
The next act will be Keen, and we're very excited.
Comparé à Coldplay ou Beautiful South, le groupe anglais Keane, formé en 97 par trois copains de lycée, s'est imposé grâce à une pop lyrique dont l'absence de guitariste est devenue une véritable marque de fabrique.
Jetzt habe ich sie bei mir, Mel C oder Melanie C, wie wir sie nennen mag, wobei wir uns auf Mel jetzt geeinigt haben. Schön, dich hier zu haben. It's a pleasure to have you here with us.
Thank you.
As it's my first time, also es ist mein erstes Mal, aber sie war ja schon öfters hier, allerdings nicht als Künstlerin. Well, I heard that you've been here before, but not as an artist, is that right?
Yeah, I actually came last year to watch my friend's band, a band called Cathead, and I just fell in love with the festival, because of all the festivals in the UK, this one really is, I think, the most laid back. There's loads of families here. There's just a really lovely atmosphere, and the weather's usually good at this festival.
Aber ganz genau, das habe ich festgestellt, dass hier sehr viele Generationen zueinander finden. Aber wie kommt das? Well, of course, I figured out there's a different kind of generation who are chilling here, who are laid back all together. But how come? What makes this festival really so special for all these families, I would say?
I think it's the history, you know. The Isle of Wight Festival, it stopped for a number of years, but, you know, it really started way back the 60s or the 70s, you know. It's a festival that really is steeped in a lot of history. Great artists have played here, and I think that's, you know, great testament is the Rolling Stones being here tonight. So you do have the, you know, the generations. You've got granddads and fathers and sons, and, you know, it's brilliant.
Und wie siehst du dich innerhalb dieser ganzen Rocker? Ich meine, heute ist ein sehr angenehmer, sanfter Tag, möchte ich sagen. And how do you feel, like, just in between all these rock bands? I mean, Paolo Nutini, James Horner might be an exception, but still, your sound should be rather smooth in comparison to all the others here.
Yeah, you know, I was a little bit nervous about, you know, coming here as a pop artist. You know, a lot of my work is influenced by rock music, but I, you know, I still know I'm a pop artist, and I always will be. But it's such a great audience that love music, and if you are up there and you are giving a good performance, then they are going to welcome you with open arms. Today has just been a dream come true for me. It's my favourite festival, and, you know, we just had so much fun on stage, and, you know, as soon as you come off, you just want to do it all again.
Thank you so much for the interview.
It's my
pleasure.
And
hope that in the near future you will be able to speak a bit more German, as I know your French is pretty good.
I know. Schule gung.
Kein Ding. Thank you.
Thank you.
Inspiré par Otis Redding, Al Green ou Stevie Wonder, James Morrison, tout juste 22 ans, est la nouvelle coqueluche de la pop soul anglaise. Il a déjà vendu plus d'un million et demi d'exemplaires de son premier album.
Just be nothing. The White Festival. Nous sommes backstage avec James Morrison. James, hi.
Bonjour.
Ça va?
Oui, ça va.
James, je regardais le concert, j'étais dans la salle, c'est incroyable, les gens ici en Angleterre, ils vous adorent, c'était la messe.
No, it wasn't that full on. I mean, yeah, I was quite surprised that there's quite a few people at the front singing along, and I knew all the words, and yeah, they're waving at me, so that was good, it was really good vibe.
Yeah, so you're waving.
Yeah, yeah. You got to say hello, you know.
People you recognize?
Well, it's just if someone waves at me, I feel obliged to wave back, you know, sometimes. So, yeah.
Since you're 22, you're very young in this business.
Yeah, definitely.
Can we talk about how you started in music? You were a busker.
Yeah, I used to play guitar when I was young, you know, when I was 13, and work out all my favorite songs and sit by the radio and do all that. And then by the time I was 14, 15, I used to go busking and earn a bit of money and just get experience, really. It's good for experience, definitely.
J'ai lu une histoire incroyable sur la façon dont vous avez été découvert. I mean, that story is so good, it cannot be true, the way you were discovered.
Yeah,
like
washing
a car and singing. Could
you
tell us?
I was a valet for a good year, part of a year, you know. I'd done loads of cruddy jobs before that, washing vans and... I was a postman and, you know, I did loads of stuff, but yeah, I got fired from my job, kind of. I got sick of it and I was unhappy, you know. I wanted to do music again, and because I've been playing gigs since I was young, so. I found a guy who had contacts with the record label through a friend of mine who we used to record together. And,
That story that you were washing a car singing Gloria.
And then some guy's like, hey, I got a contract for you.
No, that did not happen.
But it was similar. It was fast, it was very quick, and it was out of the blue, yeah.
But your voice is fantastic because it's a natural gift from God. I mean, really? Okay, do you respect that gift?
Well, I mean, I think you have to respect, I respect myself to look after it. You know, you've got to look after it. But I mean, I don't know. I feel like it's just me expressing what I feel. You know, it's normal to me. So I don't really think it's that special or whatever.
But somebody who listens to that voice, immediately you visualize a black guy living in Memphis, very wetty. Wow. They certainly made blue-eyed soul expression thinking of you, no?
Well, I do get that blue-eyed soul thing. I mean, soul to me is just what you're feeling, you know. As long as you can express what you feel, you don't need to play an R&B beat to be soulful. And yeah, that's all I go by, you know. As long as it feels good to you, and you really feel it, then that's a good sign.
Okay, thank you very much. Merci beaucoup, James.
Merci.
That was nice.